Two.
We're so excited. I hope you liked the very first video we've done. We're starting something new. What's Love Got to Do With It on our channel? We're going to be rolling right along. We have another song. This one is from the 90s. It's by a band called Extreme. It's called More Than Words. Again, the idea here is that to help you be discerning people, we are using 1 Corinthians chapter 13 as our standard to test other love songs to see if they're in fact love songs or what they got right, what they got wrong, everything in the middle. If you like this song, drop a comment. If you have any experience with this band, whether it's in concert or bought this album, whatever, drop a comment. Little fast fact, I don't know if Seth knows this, but when Van Halen was going through one of their 800 singers, one of these brothers sang for them and produced an album.
Really?
I think it was the one with the cannonball. Some guy was getting shot with a cannonball.
Yeah.
Correct me if I'm wrong. My feelings don't get hurt. But they did like a little tour. You can watch it. And it was really hard to watch. Like, this guy has a good voice, but he was super awkward with the band.
Hmm.
Anyway, side note. Let's get into it. More Than Words. Here we go. Do you know the song?
So, hardcore extreme fans are going to laugh at me here. I didn't think I knew this song until I just heard that opening thing, and now I'm reminded. This was the song that Andy from The Office, remember him and his dad did the... I never knew what the song they were singing was. I thought it was just like a casual... I had no idea that this was the song.
Hold on. Big Office fans here. If you're familiar with The Office, you love The Office, drop a comment. We like to interact with you all about stuff like that. Oh, and another thing, I don't know if you know this or not, I'll try to bring it in, but Seth, before he started his job here, I made him get a haircut. He had hair as long as these guys.
It's true.
I think this is a soft version too. I think there was like an electric version of this. Correct me if I'm wrong. I keep saying that.
They will.
They will. They will.
Words on the screen.
Do you like those? I think they're weird. You like them?
No. La dee da.
I wonder if they're all gonna do this.
I don't know.
Now that I've tried to talk to you. And turn.
Lottie dies at the end of this song.
There's a whole lot of minute left.
Yeah, I don't want to. We got the chest. And apparently, there's like another minute of oohs and ahs, but we're going to stop it there. I think we get the gist of the song. All right, so you have heard this song.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. I'm sure I have.
You've heard bits and pieces of it.
I don't remember hearing this version.
Okay.
The only thing that I've ever heard of this song was from The Office.
Right.
I don't remember a time ever hearing this song being played.
I gotcha.
It's not in my memory. However, with that being said, I dig the song big time. I like how it sounds like it's just too... It's just two guys, right?
Yeah.
Just two guys in a room with a guitar.
You're talking about musically.
Musically, yeah. Like, just how the song is being played. It kind of reminds me, which is another song I want to get to on our list, is the song Patience by Guns N' Roses, where it sounds like it's just them in a room.
Yeah.
You know, it's, yeah. But, again, the lyrics, though, is what I want to kind of get into. But I'll let you say what you want to... You want to say?
Are you pulling up the lyrics now?
Mm-hmm.
Question for everyone out there: was this? I believe this was a one-hit wonder. I don't really remember Extreme having any other songs that were popular other than this one. I'm not saying they didn't try to release things, but I don't think that anything was as popular as this one. So we just listened to Tina Turner's "What's Love Got to Do with It," and the same idea I think applies from that song to this song, and that is, when you listen to the song, it's like, wow, that's a really pretty song, you know. And I agree with Seth, the music is nice and the guys sound great. But if you were to actually divorce the words, the lyrics from the song, it actually strikes me as kind of creepy, to be honest with you. It has a very creepy vibe to it. I mean, the whole thing is him like coaxing this person he's with to use more than words, which is, of course, physical intimacy, sexuality, to prove that she loves him. So it's just a very, it's a creepy feel for me. He wants her to show him how he feels, to quote, make it real. Then he would already know.
I think that's one way you could take the lyrics. I don't think, there's nothing, I'm scanning the lyrics now. There's nothing that makes that like the direct meaning of the lyrics. Because how I took the lyrics listening to the first time is that this person is just saying, I don't want you just to say that you love me. I want you to actually show me. And which I 100% get behind with, because a lot of people use the word love. But when it comes to them actually living out what that actually looks like, a lot of people don't do that. To them, it is just about physical intimacy. It's not about sticking with the person through thick and thin. To me, it can go either one of two ways. So it's interesting that you took it, the lyrics, as he's just talking about physical intimacy, and I took it as a person just simply saying, don't just say the words you love me, actually prove it to me, actually show me that you love me. Through how you live, through how you interact with me, that kind of thing.
Yeah, I don't know. I guess it goes back to the intentions of the of the band. I don't know.
Just by saying